Welcome to the class of editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding reform eludes UN Security Council written by TP Srinivasan. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2. Plus this is very important for political science and history optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about the structures that were created in 1940s, 50s and 60s and how these structures are proving to be anachronistic, how these structures are proving to be of less use to the present situation. This editorial is also about how the unfolding of the NIEO, Neo International Economic Order, is putting up and creating a lot of pressure on the institutions that were created in 1950s, 40s and 60s to reform themselves. This editorial is also about giving a space to speak to the developing countries, the space that has been devoid, that has been eluding them from about 6 decades. Now in order to understand this editorial, we need to understand the functioning of United Nations. We also need to understand why there is a need to reform the functioning and institution of United Nations. Now as far as United Nations is concerned, it was created in the aftermath of World War II and it has on itself the imprint of the power structures that had existed at that point of time. But as of now, the power structure equations has changed, the economic condition of the countries has changed, the polarities and the multipolarities that were existing at that point of time has undergone a complete change. Now what we are witnessing is the rise of the countries like India, China, Japan, Brazil, South Africa. Now these countries, they have risen a lot from the days of 1950s. Now these countries are looking for a space in the United Nations. Now all these countries are members of United Nations, but the space that they're looking for is the space in the Security Council. Now why the Security Council is important? Now Security Council, it has with itself the band of magic. Now what is this band of magic? The band of magic is the power of vetoing the decisions. Now any member in the United Nations out of the 5 permanent members can veto a decision that has been taken in the United Nations. Now the veto power, it confers on the members a substantive power. Now the entire global democracy, now we are in the era of global governance, we are in the era of global democracy, we are in the era where the things are getting global and the local governance is shrinking day by day. The country's homogeneity, the homogeneity of all the nations and the states is on wane, and the global governance is maximizing itself. And in such a situation, it is important that the global governance structures, the global institutions, be that the institution of World Bank, be that the institution of IMF, be that the institution of United Nations, be that the organization of WTO. Now all these institutions and organizations must reflect the transparency, must manifest the equity, must manifest the equality at the global order. Now if there will be no equity at the global order, it will be difficult to establish the equity and the equality at the ground level, because as per the concept in the political science theory says that it is important to have democracy at the top. If you want it to trickle, to the bottom levels. If you want to create democracy, if you want to create human rights, if you want to create the wellness of the people, you must establish all these things at the top level. But this is something that we are really missing at the top level. The voices of the people are not heard at the top level. And now, an important change, transcendental change that has taken place is the adoption of the document for realizing the reforms in the Security Council. It is a big change. So this author, he has not accepted the thing, he has not accepted it to be a big transcendental change, but as for me, it is a big transcendental change, and it will bring about a paradigmatic change in the way the global governance is working. Though it is not easy to bring about a change in a day or two, but it will take some time. But after some years, maybe 5 years, 10 years down the lane, what we will see is the democratization of the global order. Now, what factors will dissuade this transformation, will dissuade this reform, or will dissuade this change? Kaun-kaun se factors hai jo isko change karenge? First of all, it is very difficult to dilute, to bifurcate the power that these five countries are holding, the permanent five are holding. So it will be difficult to extract power from them to share their power, because they have gone into the habit of exercising hegemony by the magic wand, by the veto power. And what these G4 countries are asking for, what India is asking for, what Japan is asking for, what Brazil is asking for, and what Germany is asking for, they are asking for a share of this veto power. Now, their justification lies in the way they have developed themselves, the justification in the way they have created creativity by entrenching themselves in the realms of social economics and politics, how they have behaved with complete and fullest of ethics and morality at the global fora. But it will be very tough for these P5 countries to share the power with these countries. Now, they will come out with n number of excuses, like why only India from Asia should be given this power? Why only South Africa should be given this permanent membership? Though South Africa is not exerting itself the way it should. In a similar manner, why only Brazil from South America? There are other countries like Argentina, there are other countries like Chile who are doing actually well. And even in continent of Africa, there are other countries apart from South Africa. Then, as far as the Asia's position is concerned, it will be not supported by China, it will not be supported by Pakistan. But the most important thing about this change that has taken place is the adoption of the resolution, adoption of the document, not the resolution. So this will formalize the things. Now, on a continuous and a sustained basis, there will be discussion on this reform thing. Till now it was informal, and now it will be formal. This is a big change. But it will be very difficult to adopt the reforms that these countries are desiring. Because whatever we are asking from these P5 countries and what we will get from them will depend on the negotiations. And the negotiations will never give you the complete thing that you would be asking. You will be getting, but you will be getting maybe 75% of that, maybe 50% of that. So what India would be getting in the day and the years to come, it might not be the permanent seat with the veto power, but it might be a pseudo veto and a pseudo permanent seat in the Security Council. Or there are chances of the restructuring of the entire UN in the days to come. But the important thing is that the change has begun. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIAS Mentors. And you can contact me at 845-940-000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And to avail the information of the classes that we are offering, please visit our website eiasmentors.com and briniki.com. And you can also install our application. Name of the application is BrainyKey. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And in case you like this video, do click on the like button to share and comment this video. And so this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.